I'm about to show you one of the great designs our engineering team and machinists concocted as an outside of the box way to increase efficiency and reduce scrap. Check this out. What do you do when the part you're machining requires more cutting tools than the number of tool positions in your machine carousel? Great question, right? Well, we were stumped by this question too, and here's what we did. We had a part. In order to machine the entire part, it required 31 cutting tools. The machine could only hold 24 cutting tools in the carousel. So we thought, what can we change to be able to make this part complete in one operation without changing things over? So to start, we just simply took our tools and hand loaded them into the spindle. Risk of that is, if someone puts the wrong tool in the machine, if they load in the wrong order, crash, boom, you have a scrap part, you might have something messed up with the machine. So we put our heads together and said, how can we change this? How can we make this part run complete from start to finish? We came up with two ways. One, we reduced the number of tools that we needed to create the part. Custom tooling, form tooling, whatever it was to reduce those numbers. We got that down to where we still needed three tools to complete this part. It worked. We were able to use it simply by hand loading the last three tools into the machine for the final part of the program. The risk was, if someone misloaded a tool or loaded the wrong tool in, you could crash, scrap the part out, or do some other type of significant damage to the machine. This is where the idea of a tool holder nest mounted right to the table of the machine was created. What we found was the design and the creation of the tool nest was the easy part. But what we had to figure out is how to teach the machine to actually change the tool here rather than the carousel. After many hours of trying to program, create code, we finally talked to the guy. The guy that had the code and the program to be able to teach it to do this, tucked away nice and neat in his email that he so likely shared with us. So using word coordinates, macros, and sub-program routines, we're now able to run a part complete using all the tools we need with this tool nest. Brian can now watch Martha Stewart and Snoop Dogg's potluck dinner party uninterrupted. That's a win-win to me. If you want to see a demonstration of some other cool out-of-the-box that we do at Kremin Incorporated, go to our YouTube channel, subscribe, and check those videos out.